So if you're considering buying a home, you may be aware that we're in a red hot seller's market, and buyers are finding themselves being urged sometimes to waive contingencies. What does that even mean? I'm Shannon Jones, and in today's episode of Home Buying 101, we're covering contingencies and what you need to know as a home buyer. So when you write an offer in California on our standard purchase agreement form, there are three contingencies in it by default, three primary contingencies. The first one is the inspection contingency, and that allows you as a buyer not only to have a physical inspection of the property, which will check the roof and the plumbing and the foundation and the electrical and all the major systems, but it also allows you as a buyer to look into whatever else is important to you. So if you want to check the crime statistics or school ratings or noise sources, if you're going to be close to a freeway or under a flight path or something like that, you can check that out. You can also check out anything else that's important. What is the commute like to your work if you're finding that you're actually going to have to go back to the office instead of continuing to work from home? That type of thing. Anything that's important to you is covered by the inspection contingency. So if you waive that completely, it means that you as a buyer now don't have the opportunity to do that due diligence. What you can do instead is shorten the contingency period. So the default is 17 days, and one of the things that you can do as a home buyer is maybe to shorten that time frame to something else, say 7 days or 5 days. Talk to your realtor to figure out how much time you'll really need to do that due diligence. So you want to be able to schedule a home inspector. If there's any other systems that, you know, may be questionable, like the roof looks like it's older or something like that, you may want to allow a little bit more time than that. Also, if it's a condo, make sure you're allowing enough time so that you'll be able to check all the condo documents. So the bylaws and the CC&Rs, those types of things. The second primary contingency that is in the contract is the loan contingency. Now the default is 21 days, but if you've already got your pre-approval and the lender has all your documents, you may want to check with them and find out how quickly did they think that they can feel really solid about your loan approval. So if you can shorten that to say 17 or 14 or even a shorter time frame, that will make your offer more appealing to the seller. If you feel very solid about your ability to obtain a loan, you may even want to waive that contingency, but again, make sure that your lender feels very, very confident and that there's not any issues potentially with your ability to get a mortgage. The third primary contingency, and the one that's getting a lot of attention, is the appraisal. So the appraisal contingency basically states that your purchase of the property is contingent upon the bank's appraiser agreeing that the property is worth the contract price. And if the appraisal comes in and it's at a lower amount, you're not obligated to move forward with the contract. So there's several different options. You either could cancel, you could agree to pay more than what the appraisal comes in at, but the bank is only going to loan you an amount based on that appraisal value, or you and the seller might renegotiate the price. So if there's a question about whether or not the property's appraisal is going to come in at the price you're offering, you want to think very carefully about whether or not that's a contingency that you're comfortable waiving. What we're finding is that sometimes buyers are waiving that contingency to be competitive, and then they're sort of freaking out when the appraisal comes in lower than the contract price. Don't put yourself in that position. Review comparable sales very carefully with your real estate agent prior to making an offer, and then discuss whether or not that's a contingency that you want to waive, or maybe you want to modify it. Maybe you simply want to shorten that contingency time frame, or you could use what's called an appraisal gap clause. So you're modifying that contingency to say, I'm okay paying above the appraised value, but only X amount. If you have any questions about contingencies, how they work, how the contract works, or the process, definitely reach out, let us know, and we're happy to help. Thanks for watching.